Another one that I think you also see a lot of today are the one that I called numbskull. Can you read my handwriting? That's a U when I put that. Numbskulls, sometimes they're called noodlehead stories too. And they're stories about people who think they're kind of clever, but they're actually very, very stupid. And they get into one scrape after another because of what they think is a clever idea turns out to be a really bad idea. There's this very famous Norwegian story about the man who was going to keep house, you know, or another very famous, sometimes they're called jack tales, and in Latin America, they're always story about a character named Pedro. He's always, you know, very, and in Germany, he's always called Hans. In England, there's a very funny story called The Three Sillies. And I don't have time to tell you the whole story, but it'll get you the general idea. It's about this young woman who's being courted by this guy. And so her parents have him over for dinner, and they serve him this nice meal, but he runs out of beer. So she, of course, jumps up and says, let me refill, you know, this. And so she takes the mug, and she goes down into the basement where they have a big keg, and she opens up the tap and put the mug underneath, but it's a very slow drip. So she sits down on the stairs to wait. And as she's sitting there, she's kind of looking around, and she sees that there's an axe stuck in the beam in the ceiling. And she goes, oh, what if me and my sweetheart were to get married? And what if we had a little child, and that child was a little boy? And what if he came down here one day to get some, you know, ale for his father? And what if the axe got loose from the ceiling and hit him in the head? He could kill him. So she just starts bawling at the thought of what possibly could happen one day and forgets to come upstairs with the beer. So her mother wants to know, you know, what's going on. So she comes downstairs and says, well, sweetheart, what's the matter? And she says, I came down here and I noticed there was an axe stuck in the beam in the ceiling. And I thought, what if me and my sweetheart get married and we have a little boy one day and he comes down to fetch some beer for his father? And what if the axe got loose from the ceiling? It could kill him. And the mother said, oh, that'd be so terrible. So then she starts crying too. These people are not too bright. So then, of course, the father comes down, and there's his wife, and there's his daughter. Beer is spilling all over the place. He goes, oh, what happened? So he gets the whole story, and he goes, oh, and he starts crying. So now the sweetheart's sitting all alone upstairs. You know, where are they? He goes downstairs to see what happened. And so they tell him this whole story, and he can't not believe. And he goes, oh, my gosh, you know, you three are the silliest three people I've ever met in my life, and I am leaving, and I'm never coming back unless I meet three sillies sillier than the three of you. And he just storms out of the house. And then, of course, now they really fall to crying because the girl has lost her sweetheart. But he goes off, and on his way, sort of shaking his head, he comes to this farm, and he sees this very strange sight. There is this farmer, and he's trying to push his cow up a ladder onto the sod roof. And he goes, what are you doing? He goes, well, said the farmer, isn't it obvious? I mean, there's green grass right here on my roof. Why should I take the cow for a mile's walk to get to pasture when I could just put him up here on the roof? Said the man, aren't you afraid it's going to fall off? Not at all, says the man. I'm just going to tie a rope around his neck, put it down the chimney. I'll go inside, tie the other end of the rope to my leg, and I'll go about doing my business. Well, the man doesn't think it's so good, but he sort of waits around to see what happens. And after a couple of hours of shoving this poor cow up a ladder, he finally gets the cow up, ties the rope around his neck, drops it down the chimney, ties the other end to his, you know, and starts to cook and, you know, meddle around. But of course, it doesn't last very long before the cow falls off the roof, and there's no gentle tug on the leg. Instead, the man goes thump, shooting up the chimney, gets stuck, and would have, in all likelihood, suffocated up there, and the cow strangled if the man hadn't cut the rope and let them both fall down. So he just shakes his head and goes, well, that's one big silly, you know, and he walks on. It's late. He finds an inn for the night, and well, it's full, so he has to share the room with another man, which is fine because he's really tired, goes to bed. Early next morning, he wakes up, there's this huge racket. He rubs his eyes and he looks, and here's this guy, and he's like had his pair of pants hanging there, and he's in his underwear, and he's taking his running start, and he's leaping, trying to leap into the pants. And he goes, and he's run, can't do it, of course, back and forth, back and forth. Finally, the man says, what are you doing? You know, they're such a complicated invention, these kinds of pants. You know, it takes me the better part of the morning to put them on every single day. Oh, Cincinnati, I can't believe this. It's never occurred to you that you could sit down on your bed and just take the pants and put one leg in at a time and then stand up and pull them on? Wow, Cincinnati, that is brilliant. I had never thought so. So, you know, it's another big silly. He gets to another town, and here the people are up in arms at the end of the day because they think the moon has fallen into a pond. Of course, it's just a reflection. When he tries to explain it, he gets chased out of town. So now he's met more than three sillies sillier than the three at home, and he has got to go home and marry his sweetheart because he is a man of his word. But as to whether or not they were happy, now that's another tale to tell. So that's the kind of story that's called the numbskull story. And I think there's a lot of television shows. I just watched Home Improvement yesterday, and it struck me that Home Improvement is one numbskull tale. Can you think of any others?
Tweety Bird.
Oh, Tweety Bird's a good example. Tom and Jerry, very good example. How about The Simpsons? That's often that way. Any others? You can, I think sometimes that Seinfeld, especially George, George has a lot of schemes that are just exactly like this, right? So there's very many shows on television, nearly all sitcoms have a lot of that kind of element in it.